Okay, you want to say anything? Say hi, guys. Welcome to Auntie Denise's
Sorry,
channel.
Guys. His bib cannot get this stuff expensive.
My
dirty.
Boss. Say welcome to Auntie Denise's channel. Yeah, I know. Say like, share, subscribe. Guess who's going to the zoo? You going zoo? You go see friends? Huh? You go see friends? LJ, you gonna go see friends? You are? Uh-huh. Yeah, really? Oh, okay. Ben. 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 Boo. I know. Boo. Say bye, guys. See you at the zoo. Bye. What's up, fam? So we are finally here. We finally arrived. But there's no thingies to pram. Just follow that lady, because that doesn't have a pram thingy. We're finally here at Taronga Zoo, guys. So I'll be vlogging throughout the day. It is LJ's 6 months. He turned 6 months, so we decided to come to the zoo. That's why we're here. Lance, CJ, Vanya. Yeah, I'll be vlogging throughout. First time actually to the zoo with LJ. I haven't been to the zoo in like for ages. So we're gonna vlog. Bye, guys. Where are we at, CJ?
We are at
for the millionth time we've told them we're at the Taronga Zoo.
Yeah.
Oh, CJ, show us your phone.
Oh, guys.
Hey, don't be a show off.
No, dude.
Hello.
Yeah, I've got a new phone. Yeah, I don't know how long it's gonna last.
Excuse me, CJ, LJ, how do you feel about going to the zoo today? Huh? How do you feel? See. First things first, LJ needs a feed.
Yeah, sorry.
LJ, look, koala. Look, koala. It's right there, guys, in the tree. Look, Blinky Bill. Look.
It's so cute. So lonely. Up.
Can you take a photo of us, please?
Excuse me, no. LJ, giraffe, look. Over there. Got some giraffes over there, guys. Woohoo. What is it? Is it orangutans or yucky? Yucky.
They're the orange, brownish looking.
Say hi. Say hi. Oh.
Yeah, Auntie Denise, like lonely way.
Bye. Gotta fly. Oh my goodness.
Is his eyes alright? Is he squinting?
Nah, he's like. Having this
album. Wait, put him first.
That is so cute. Hi! Baba, LJ. Ben, 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 Ben. LJ. Oh, say hi, friend. Say hi. They're so cute. It's a meerkat, guys. Heaps of zoo. Someone's gone skis. Excuse me. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. Anyways, let's go see some elephant knees. Hi, elephant. How are they treating you here? Are you well? Oh my gosh, they're so beautiful. I just, wow.
It might wake you
alright.
It might put
some water
in your trunks and give a big.
Alright, guys, so I've seen the giraffe. What else did we see? The giraffes, the koala, the meerkats,
apes.
After seeing all that, deuces. After seeing all that, we're about to have a feed because we're actually quite hungry. I'm hungry actually. So there's a door, there's a barricade, I guess, in a way, to stop people from, you know, disobeying the disobeying the rules, I guess.
Not that long.
Yeah. So we're gonna have some. I'm gonna have fish and chips. I'll vlog when I eat it. What are you gonna give it, baby?
I don't know.
LJ fell asleep while we were going to the elephants. Yeah, so it's just what a difference this COVID has created. Just the distancing, the social activity that is and isn't allowed.
Social distancing things.
I actually wore socks. I was watching a lot of people and they were wearing, like, obviously walking shoes, and I decided to wear socks. It's very comfortable, y'all. Anyways, bye guys. Guess who's awake?
You awake? Who put his bib like that? It was his.
Fix his bib right now. I think so.
Mum be like.
Where are we? Oh, sorry.
Oh, where are we?
Wow, look at that so far. Look at that. See the waterfall. Look at the waterfall. Hi. Alright, let's go. We're actually going to the toilet to change his nappy. Where's the toilet?
Right there. I touched it.
Seal. That was beautiful. LJ's looking at the seals, guys. Look. You saw the seal, Papa.
Yeah. Now there's a bag.
Say hi to the tiger, it's over there. Look. King of the jungle. Tiger. No, you cannot touch it. Wow, man, this guy loves a camera. Go. Go, say hi, YouTube. Say like, share, subscribe. He's so cheeky. Dude, he fully knows the camera. Every time he sees it, he's like, yeah!
He knows phones now. But you ain't getting one to your 50.
And that's a wrap, guys, here at the zoo, Taronga Zoo, Sydney, for LJ's 6 months. He turned 6 months on Wednesday, on the 17th, actually. So we thought we'll just bring him to the zoo to celebrate. He has thoroughly enjoyed himself. And so have I. I haven't actually been to the zoo in like ages, so it was good to come through and spend time. We look forward to bringing him again. So yeah, it was good to take photos as well. Memories, creating memories, and creating everlasting and never-ending adventures with each other and those around you is important. The materialistic things that we get in life don't last, but these memories do. So yeah, but I'll do that, guys. Peace out. Bye. Whoa, spirit, what's the heavens open? Yeah, spirit, can you hear it calling? Hey guys. Okay, so it went from like sunny days to like rainy days. Boy. Right. So yeah, it's gone from like sunny as, which was yesterday, to like freezing cold, and it's like rainy and like, look at that. Like rainy for days. Whoop. Yeah, so I'm just heading off to Tina's for brunch and to catch up on a few things, and I'm running out of breath. And I literally walk from the kitchen to the door. Anyways, yeah, and so catching up on that. Hope you guys have enjoyed watching LJ going to the zoo for the very first time. Yes, I haven't been to the zoo in like forever, like since like probably high school days or even school days, young days, but it was really good, had so much fun. I will share a devotions / final thoughts at the end of this video. All right guys, peace out. I need to go buy some bread before I go to Tina's. Bye. Hey guys, so that wraps up another vlog that is the week that was. We went to the zoo and it was LJ's first, well, this thing is going on my head, LJ's first time at the zoo, which was so good. Yes, hit the wall. Anyway, so obviously as we come to the end of my vlog, I just wanted to, I guess, touch a little on what's happening around the world, especially an incident that happened in Melbourne with one of our young Polynesian gentlemen, and the effect it has on the actual Pacifica community and the young ones and all of that. And we acknowledge it first and foremost, and we are praying and just entrusting it all into God's hand. There is nothing that is too small or too insignificant for God to move in. And as we trust and surrender it all into his hands, we trust that the Holy Spirit are speaking to those young ones who are angry, who are frustrated, who don't know what to do or how to respond to it. And we are really uplifting and truly trusting in God to just move. And so CJ, he's literally probably CJ's age, or even probably, yeah, same age. And to think that he went to school like any other normal day, and then that was literally the last day he was at school. And so I just cannot fathom how that happens. And the enemy is just so real and is here, and he tries to, see that, see, not today, no, I'm kidding. And he just tries to ruin, manipulate, and destroy. He's here to kill, destroy, and to kill and destroy, basically. And so God and our Father God, Jesus, has overcome that all. So I just wanted to actually, I asked my brother to come and send prayers to the families of those who are affected, and to his family, his friends, who are mourning, who are going through a season of mourning. And I pray healing, and we just really commit and surrender them into his hands, and that you are not alone, and that we are in this together. And praying for those as well, the young ones who want to retaliate, and however way it is that they try to react to this, don't. One mistake, literally one mistake, boom, finished. And that's what he wants. That's what the enemy wants, for you to just step into that one mistake, into that one thing that he's drilling into your mind to do. Boom. Kill, destroy, kaput. And so don't fall into that mindset, into what he's trying to say into your life. But yeah, so yep. He's gonna pray, and then I'm gonna share a bit of a devotion, and then God's good. Do you have anything to say, actually?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
You nervous?
Yeah.
But yes, so yep. Right, over to you.
Okay. Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you, Lord, that we are here today, Lord. I pray,
you,
Lord, that I thank you, Lord, for bringing us here today, Lord, that we can be in your presence, Lord. I just want to pray, Lord, for the family in Melbourne, Lord, who have recently lost their son, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, I'm praying, Lord, that I'm sending all my prayers to the family, Lord, that they are okay, Lord, and Lord, that you are always with them, Lord, and that they may know that everything happens for a purpose, Lord, and that they will stay in your presence, Lord. I pray, Lord, thank for the teenagers who may be affected by this, Lord, or his friends and anyone just who knew him, Lord. I pray, Lord, that you may bless them, Lord. You may be with them, Lord, and know that he's spiritually there with them, Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I pray, Lord, for the family, Lord, of that all the hard times they're going through right now, Lord, especially the COVID-19 crisis, Lord, that you may bless them, Lord, that you are with them, Lord, and that you'll always guide them and protect them all. Mm. In Jesus' name, pray. Amen.
Amen and amen. Thank you.
Okay, class.
Bye. So yeah, guys, like it's just such a, it's like you can't fathom the things that are happening around the world. But we know that in these moments, in these times, that we are resting in God's truth, resting in His Word, and trusting that all it will get better. And I know it's like, man, that's easier for you to say because you haven't lost it, but it will get better. And so today's devotion, what day is it today? And that's my little brother, like he's literally the same age, and it just hits home, and you're just like praying and just surrendering those who are angry, who are frustrated, who don't know how to respond, but instead they react to everything that happens in their lives. So June 21st, so it says, the Good Shepherd. God promises to look after His sheep, to care for them and to bring them back to safety. God wants to be your shepherd too. You are part of God's flock, and He is the shepherd who will look after you. For this, and so in Ezekiel 34 verse 11 to 16, 25 to 27 and 30 to 31, I'll put that in the down below. So this is what the Sovereign Lord says. I myself will search and find my sheep. I will be like a shepherd looking for his scattered flock. I will find my sheep and rescue them from all the places where they were scattered on that dark and cloudy day. I will bring them back home to their own land of Israel, from among the peoples and nations. Yes, I will give them good pasture land on the high hills of Israel. There they will lie down in pleasant places and feed in the lush pastures of the hills. I myself tend my sheep and give them a place to lie down in peace, says the Sovereign Lord. I will search for my lost ones who strayed away, and I will bring them safely home again. I will bandage the injured and strengthen the weak. I will make a covenant of peace with my people and drive away the dangerous animals from the land. Then they will be able to camp safely to the wildest places and sleep in the woods without fear. I will bless my people in their homes around my holy hill, and in the proper season, I will send the showers they need. They will be showers of blessings. The orchards and fields of my people will yield bumper crops, and everyone will live in safety. When I've broken the chains of slavery, rescued them from those who enslaved them, then they will know that I am the Lord. In this way, they will know that I, the Lord their God, am with them. You are my flock, the sheep of pasture. You are my people, and I am your God. The Good Shepherd. Like, that's a word of encouragement for you all for this week, for the week that is about to be. And also, I just also want to put out a message that our senior pastor David, shared on today, actually. Very, very, very good. I was really blessed and encouraged by that message. I'll put the link up in here, or maybe it's over here. Either or, just click on that eye and then you'll see it. Go and check it out. Hope you are encouraged by that. It's like foundational truth that we are reminded of, that we tend to forget when everything else is going wild and crazy. This is a foundational truth that our faith is based on, and as well as our church itself and where our church stands in these whole situations. So be blessed, and have a fabulous week. God loves you so much, and I love you too. And yeah, it's that cold right now. It is that cold. All right, peace. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Peace out, fam. This is Denise and Tuffa, over and out. Bye 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 bye.